Tell the Truth, episode 0824, take one.
Report that we have just finished skipping with more or less grace down the long yellow brick road from the Land of Oz. We have with us today the fellow who created a place called the Land of Oz, an actual location. And we'll meet him as soon as our panel has said hello to the Tin Woodman, to Dorothy, to the Scarecrow, and to the poor cowardly lion. Let's meet our wizard of a panel here on To Tell the Truth.
Gene Rayburn! Peggy Cass! Alan Posten! And Kitty Carlisle!
Now, don't tell me we don't get you escorted onto this stage in class.
That was delicious.
A delightful group of people? Obviously, we're all off on a trip to the Emerald City to see the Wizard of Oz. Now, Dorothy will be back on our stage to introduce her charming companions, but first, there'll be a small detour on the Yellow Brick Road while we deposit some long green in the Emerald City. Now, let's meet the man who has recreated the Land of Oz. And, Dorothy, I think it's only proper that you do the honors, my dear.
Number one, what is your name, please?
My name is Jack Penton.
Number two?
My name is Jack Penton.
Number three?
My name is Jack Penton.
Name is Jack Penton. You're having a little trouble hearing through those. It'll be better when they get over on the mics. So here is the story of Jack Penton. It says, I, Jack Penton, have created an actual Land of Oz, high on a mountain where visitors can come and become part of this famous children's story. The magic begins when our guests accompany a real-life Dorothy out of her Kansas farmhouse, which has been dropped by a cyclone, into the Land of Oz. And there, Dorothy and her dog start off on the yellow brick road, which leads to her meetings with that famous trio, the Scarecrow and the Tin Woodman and the Shivery, Shakery, Cowardly Lion. And then the four friends on their travels meet the Wicked Witch, who is brewing some evil mess in a kettle. When she sees Dorothy and her friends, she tries to cast a spell on them, but they run away and find themselves finally at the Emerald City. And after a joyous tour of the city and a meeting with the Great Wizard, Dorothy waves goodbye and sets off in the Wizard's giant balloon to go back home again to Kansas. My Land of Oz, of course, owes a debt both to the famous book and to the movie, The Wizard of Oz. At the entrance to our Land of Oz, there is a statue of Judy Garland, who was, of course, Dorothy in the film. And the first shovel full of dirt was dug at our groundbreaking by the original Scarecrow himself, Ray Bolger. Signed, Jack Penton. And we'll start the questioning with our fairy queen, Kitty Carlisle.
Oh, thank you. Oh, I want to go there desperately, fellas. Where is it? Number three, where is it?
It's on Beach Mountain.
Where's that?
In North Carolina.
Oh, and number two, does it go all year round?
We have a season, 4 months.
And number one, who wrote the original book?
L. Frank Baum.
Ah, and number three, how much does it cost to get in?
We charge $4 for the adults and $2.50 for children.
And number two, can you stay all day?
The tour takes about 3 hours.
How, 3 hours? And number one, are you all actors?
No.
Oh, you're just local townspeople?
Me nodded. I guess that means just local townspeople. We go to Gene.
Yeah. Number three, are you having a little trouble with your lower jaw there?
Remember, I'm the Cowardly Lion.
Oh, that's right. You're trembling. Your lower jaw is trembling because you're afraid of me, right, number three? Number three, who was inside that Cowardly Lion costume in the motion picture?
That was Bert Lahr.
Yes. Number two, who was inside of your costume in the motion picture?
Jack Hale.
Yes. How long has this been going, number one?
It opened last year for its first season in 1971.
Is it hot inside that coconut shell, number one?
It's roasting.
It is roasting.
His chestnut is roasted, I can tell you. Let's go to Peggy.
Number two, how many shows will you do a day?
One set of people, one set of performers do two shows each.
And how many sets of performers do you have?
We have four Dorothys, and each Dorothy has her own troupe.
Oh, I see. Number three, what was Dorothy's aunt's name?
Her name was Auntie M.
Thank you. And number one, who played Glinda in the movie, the Good Witch Glinda?
That was Billy Burke.
Thank you. And number...
There goes your buzzer, which takes us to Tom.
How many acres, number two?
There's 26 acres.
My word. Number three, is this a public company?
Oh, it's a private organization.
Is it? Number one, how old is it?
The Land of Oz is one season old.
Ronnie and Tony Martini, Mr. and Mrs. Martini, what do they have to do with that place, number three?
I don't recall having much to do with it.
You don't know Ronnie and Tony Martini, Mr. and Mrs.?
No, I don't.
Okay, number two, do you know whether this is a public company or not?
It's the Carolina Caribbean Corporation.
That's... Thank
you. And there goes the bell. And no matter what you think you learned, you got to put a number down on the ballot. And, of course, it must be a one or a two or a three. And it's $50 for a wrong vote. It's $500 for a clean sweep. And Kitty Carlisle starts.
I'm going to vote for number two. He said the name of a company that sounded very legitimate to me.
Okay.
And I voted for him.
So we have a two showing in Gene Rayburn.
Well, it's tough, Gary, because, you know, they're inside there, and we really can't see their eyes, and the eyes are revealing. In this case, if someone were trying to be an imposter and someone asked the name of the corporation, you just wouldn't ad-lib Carolina Caribbean Corporation. So for that logic, number two got my vote.
Uh-huh. Two and two, and Peg.
Well, I never heard of the Martini family, but the Carolina Caribbean company is so exotic that I had to vote for number two.
It's sweeping down the line. We got three twos, and what are you going to do?
I voted for number two as well. I happen to know a little tiny bit about this, but I think I may have the name wrong, but I think the Martinis are out in front of the place.
They're
such lovebirds. Everybody in Western Carolina knows about
it. Well, this is the way it goes now. Everybody is unanimous. We're either terribly right or terribly wrong. Everybody says number two. So, will the real Jack Pentis please stand up? It's a clean sweep. Great shot, fellas. You won $500. Number two, will you tell us what your real name is and what do you do?
My name is Nipsey Russell. I made this suit with an acetylene torch. It's neither pleated nor belted. I would have been dressed in the latest style, but the doggone hot pants melted.
Isn't that marvelous? Unanimously, everybody went for Nipsey, and every one of you knows him.
Oh, well, that's what we get there. We're having a celebrity on the thing. Let's go to number three. Number three, what is your real name and what do you do?
My name is,
I can't believe
Johnny Olson.
Johnny Olson, our fine announcer and confrere. John, when did you get into the costume?
During the first commercial, Garry. I disappeared.
And that is why we had Dorothy come out and introduce the guests, you see.
You're a very good actor, Johnny.
Thank you very much.
Good job prior to that.
Good job for everybody.
Roger Peterson was in prior to that.
And Jack, quite quickly now, where exactly is the Land of Oz located?
It's on the top of Beach Mountain near Banner Elk, North Carolina, which is between Boone and Linville in the Blue Ridge area.
Hope to see you there soon. Nipsey, I see you backstage. Johnny, go back to work.
Yes, I did.
Thanks very much, friends, on behalf of Propel the Truth. You got a good eye there, Posten, right?
Oh, I'm so glad that we didn't get him. Wasn't that terrific? I love it when we're all wrong. Why is that?
Well, you know, Tom, when he's not working here, I should put it the other way around. He works for Providence Securities down on Wall Street, and we get a day off from him every now and then. Are you as smart about your stocks and bonds and your securities as you are about your voting?
I just missed, Garry.
You better get back to the shop.
You got all the heart of a tin woodman.
I know it. It's just terrible. Well, let's get back to what we're doing here. You know, when young people go away to college, they are likely to be a bit homesick. And, of course, one of the best cures for that is to have a kindly, understanding, and friendly house mother. Well, our next guest on To Tell the Truth is just that and a little bit more. You'll see what I mean after a couple of messages here. Oh, Johnny, are you back at your post now?
Yes, I'm back, ready to introduce the next guest, Garry.
Oh, you remember how it goes now. It's what is your name and all like
My
that?
My name is... Yeah, I remember.
Okay, you got it? Here we go, then. Let us then meet our very special house mother.
Number one, what is your name, please?
My name is Sarah Sue Ritchie.
Number two...
My name is Sarah Sue Ritchie.
Number three.
My name is Sarah Sue Ritchie.
And only one of them, of course, is Sarah Sue Ritchie, and this is the story. I, Sarah Sue Ritchie, am a fraternity house mother. I know I don't look like the traditional gray-haired motherly image of a house mother. In fact, the fraternity members thought I was too young for the job and looked in vain for a house mother in the more conventional mold. Finally, they gave up and hired me on a temporary basis, which was quickly made permanent when they discovered that I was able to plan good meals, chaperone their parties, and generally make the house comfortable to live in. In fact, I am such a success as a house mother that all the boys in the house have a special nickname for me. They call me Super Sarah. Signed, Sarah Sue Ritchie. We'll start with a guy who appreciates a pretty girl, even if she is a house mother, Tom Posten.
Well, number two, it's obvious that you're a very attractive young lady. What do you do if a young man gets ardent?
They usually don't, out of hand.
What about the ones that... Did anybody ever?
At the SAE house? Or ever? Yes, at one time.
What do you do about that?
Just try to handle it with discretion.
Well, I think it's fantastic. If you'd seen our... Number three, how did you go into the line of work in the first place?
Well, actually, my boyfriend is with another house on the campus, and he heard that they were looking for somebody, and it didn't really originate with me. There are other graduate students doing it on the campus.
Oh, I thought you were a college girl. Number one, are you a graduate student?
Yes, I am.
And where is the school, may I ask?
In Alabama. Tuscaloosa.
What's the fraternity?
SAE.
Oh, you can trust them. They wouldn't harm a girl. They wouldn't harm a girl. They'd be lucky if they ever... Number two, are the Sigma News on your... Where are you, number two?
At the University of Alabama in Tuscaloosa.
And from Tom, we go to Kitty, please.
Well, number one, you say you chaperone their parties. I didn't know there was such a thing left as a chaperone.
Well, I'm the official chaperone for the parties.
What does that mean? You're there, but you disappear?
Discreetly.
Number two, why would they even have to have a sort of a figurehead for a chaperone with parietal things they have now?
It's a university rule.
It is. Mm-hmm. And number three, what are you studying?
Oh, I'm in home ec with foods and nutrition.
Oh,
now,
so you
now
can plan
grad
meals.
School, right.
Number two, what do you do to make the house livable?
See that there are flowers there on certain occasions and that the meals are on time and this sort of thing.
I see. Number one, I thought fraternities were dying out, maybe not in the South.
No, not in the South at all. They're very strong.
They are. And number two, do you approve of fraternities in general?
Yes.
Why?
I was a sorority girl myself, so I approve.
What was your sorority?
Pi Beta Phi.
And do you approve of sororities and fraternities, number three?
I have various thinkings about them. I think the SAE house is great, and when I was a sorority member, I enjoyed it very much. I have a lot of different ideas about it.
And that takes us on down to G.
Very interesting. They didn't have this when I was a kid.
You'd have never graduated.
That's right. Number two, how many boys are there?
There are about 30 that live in the house, but I feed 80 to 90 at the noon meal.
That's quite a job to feed that many. Number three, is there any, on many campuses around America now, there's co-ed living. Has that happened at your school?
No, it hasn't, not yet.
No? Why are you laughing, number three?
Well, I don't know.
Like
maybe I'd move back into the dorm.
I see. Number one, would you tell us, number two told us, now you tell us how you handle it when one of the boys gets ardent, as Tom put it, and makes a pass at you. What do you do?
I sit down and tell him the facts of life.
Yeah, but he knows the facts of life. That's why he's making a pass at you, honey.
That's what he sat down for.
Number three, I guess we have to follow this all the way. How do you handle it?
Well, you mean how do I handle it?
Yeah, what do you do if a kid gets amorous and...
Well, in the SAE house, let me say, when I moved there, we thought that might be a problem, and the fraternity president called a big meeting, you know, and he says that we can have it going on, and the guys are pretty good about it, really.
And Peggy?
Number three, I don't think we established where you are. Which school are you...
Alabama.
The University of Alabama.
Right.
Okay, now, number two, how do you get all your work done when you have to feed 92 people three times a day? I mean, you're a graduate student, right? What
right.
are you graduating in, dishwashing?
No, foods and nutrition. I have a staff of four, and they're pretty well organized. If I give them the menu, they can carry on.
Okay. Well, number one, do you have to figure out, like, for 92 people, how much you can spend? I mean, do you have to make it up out of a budget? Do you have to figure the budget out?
I don't have to figure the budget out, but we do work with the budget.
You mean like number one, at the end of the month, is it pretty much rice and grits?
No, it isn't.
Well, that's good to know. Number three, what is the fraternity song of SAE?
The fraternity song?
Yeah.
We don't really have a song, or at least none that I can think of.
They did at Harvard.
They have a yell that I couldn't repeat right. But I don't know really of any song. This is my first semester actually at Alabama, and also my first with the house.
Number one, if anybody,
there goes the bell. I hope we've made up our minds. Is it number one, or is it number two? Or what do you think, is it number three? We pay $50 for each wrong guess. We pay five, I know. We pay $500 if all the votes are wrong, as they were last time. Tom, you want to try?
Shall I? Yeah. I voted for number two because I think I detected just a fleck of tapioca on her lapel. And it...
You're nasty.
Oh,
we've
don't
got
you
a two
remember
show
how much
in there.
Tapioca we
hey, let's go to Kitty.
Well, they were all wonderful. It could be any of them. But I voted for number three because I think she's new at it, and she wasn't all that certain of everything.
We got a two and a three, and Gene Rayburn's coming out any minute.
Well, I voted for number two because I'd like to try her cooking.
There you go, Peg.
Well, I think number three should have known that they do have a song. They do, at least the...
Sing it for us, Peg.
No, I voted for number two.
What?
All of us?
We know. We got three twos and one three showing, and let's find out about this. If you're an SAE, you ought to know. Will the real Sarah Sue Ritchie please stand up?
Come on, Sarah Sue.
Yes.
Hey.
Sarah Sue, be back to you in a minute. Let's find out about your friends. Number one, what is your real name, please, and what do you do?
My name is Carol Potter, and I'm a publicist at the American Broadcasting Company.
Oh. And number three, please, what is your real name? What do you do?
My name is Elena Yates, and I'm a representative for a monochromatic wig company.
Sarah Sue, is there such a song as Peggy says there is?
If there is, I don't know it.
They haven't taught it to you yet.
Well, I thought like number three was just trying to fudge out.
I know there is one.
There is a song. Do you know how it goes, Peggy?
No, I forget.
Now, when you're chaperoning, you know, at a party, are you allowed to bring a date yourself?
Yes. Uh-huh. I'm just like one of the gang, really.
You're just one of the boys.
Not one of the boys. I didn't say that.
You wouldn't fool me for a minute. Thank you, Sarah Sue, and thank you, friends, also, for being here with us on To Tell the Truth.
In addition to the cash awards, our first team of challengers will receive exquisite gold and tassel jewelry by Sarah Coventry. A necklace with gold and tone chains converts to a bracelet and matching earrings, all designed by Sarah Coventry. Our second team will receive Carousel's Dolly M wig and Flexicurl, the creative new hair thing, both in 26 exclusive colors from Carousel, America's largest wig manufacturer.
Panel, when you're working on a show, whether it be a Broadway show or a television show, do you ever make little notes in the margin to yourself some interpretation, and then after you read it 2 days later, you don't know what it means?
Yes.
No.
Yeah.
Believe it or not, and I'm reading to you, this is the last card for today, and it says here, in my own handwriting, it's possible that Aristotle Onassis has ingrown toenails.
What does that mean?
I haven't the vaguest idea, and I wrote it to myself.
What's it in connection with?
He doesn't
I don't know.
I read the rest of
Friends,
the card.
Friends, come see me in the hospital. I'm going to be ill for a while. Meanwhile, I'm going to try again tomorrow.
In addition to the cash awards, our central characters today will receive the Samsonite Classic Attaché Case, featuring color-coordinated portfolio and exterior-strong magnesium frames and stain-resistant cover from Samsonite. Transportation and other considerations provided by Chevrolet, featuring the new Monte Carlo. Still the only personal luxury car you can buy for anything near the price, luxury-style craftsmanship plus traditional Chevrolet value. Prizes or product mentions are furnished and or paid for by the manufacturers or supplier of the products or services identified on this program. This is Johnny Olson speaking for To Tell the Truth, a Mark Goodson, Bill Topman production.
Oh, it's fun, isn't it?
And who subscribes to it?
Go on.
Push the button.
Think of the fun you could have on
the tube.
The tube?
You.
Tube.
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 TV tubes.
That's a lot of fun, isn't it?
It's going to be a lot more fun
if you keep going the way you're going.
Go on. Push the button.
Please subscribe. Subscribe.
I hope they're watching.